Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. www.punarvasi.com. In this website, I am writing different articles on step-by-step procedures of SAP Basis Administration. You can go through my articles to learn SAP Basis Administration very easily. So I am Mr. Ross, SAP Basis International Trainer. I have conducted training in 55 countries. In this video, I am going to explain you how to extend Oracle database table space in an SAP system. Here, this is my server which I have connected using remote desktop connection. I have minimized, just I am maximizing it. And in the server, I have installed SAP Nature software using VMware Workstation. And I have used the same system for performing different types of SAP Basis Administration experiments. And you can also have same type of environment to perform your tasks, means your experiments. And let us see what all the SAP systems are installed in this system. So there are four SAP systems installed. Out of four SAP systems, just I am taking this system, that is DEV system, for this particular experiment to perform. To extend table space in the Oracle database of an SAP system, you need to use BR tools from the command prompt. So there is no need to start the SAP system to extend table space. Only thing is that database should be mounted and it is opened. And let us check whether the database is opened or not. Go to command prompt, type sql plus slash nolog, and this is the SQL prompt. From here, type connect slash as sysdba and it is connected. Now let us type startup command. The startup command will start the Oracle database if it is not already started, and it will give the information saying that it is already started. Just hit enter to get the information. Cannot start already running Oracle, shut it down first. If you want, you can shut down once. How to shut down? SHUT shutdown immediate. And once it is shut down, Oracle database is shut down, you can use the startup command to start it again. Okay, if it is not shutting down properly, just restart your SAP system and restart. If it is taking long time for shutting down, you can restart your SAP system once. So once it is restarted, just log on to the system using corresponding user account, that is DEVADM account. In this case, DEV is the system identifier. Just type the password here. Just go to command prompt directly and type the command sql plus slash no log and connect slash as sysdba and connect it to an idle instance. Now you can start it up. So it will allocate a system global area and it will allocate different buffers and database is mounted and database should be open now. Yes, database is open now. And now you can also check the Oracle network, that is using DNS ping. DNS ping, DEV is the SID, that is system identifier, Oracle system identifier. And you should get OK message like this, 0 milliseconds. Just come out of from this screen. Again, go to command prompt. And just type BR tools. BR tools will be used for Oracle administration of an SAP system. And BR tools has been developed by SAP AZ for simplicity of Oracle database administration. And the system administrators can use this particular command to perform almost all the activities of database administration. Just hit enter. From the main screen, just select second option, that is space management option. So we are going to extend table space, so that you have to select second option, that is space management. Hit enter. And this is called choice menu 5. And database space management choice menu. Here, wherever you are seeing equal to sign, that particular function will be performed. When you type C from your keyboard, hit enter. That is extend table space. We are going to extend the table space. Just hit enter. And here, and whatever the options, that is BR space. BR space is a command again. Within the BR tools, BR space is one function. And BR space options for table space extension, and whatever the options it has given here, just accept by entering C from your keyboard. And in the next screen, it will give you complete command, what command it is going to execute. And again, you can type C to continue. That is, you see here, BR space will be started with options hyphen P, the profile, and the command is TS extend. You can also start this command from your command prompt using br space hyphen f ts extend along with the options. Just type C here, hit enter. So this is table space extension main menu. From here again, you see the equal to sign and type C from your keyboard, hit enter to extend table space. And it will show you all the table spaces are available in this system, in this Oracle database. And this is the table space I am using for this experiment, that is PSAP SR3 RAS 2. And it has three data files. Just you can also have a look at file system level about those three data files. Oracle Home, DEV, SAP Data 4. Under this, you see this folders 1, 2, 3. So under each folder you can see one file, second file, and third file. Size of this third file is 100 MB and second file is 100 MB and first file is 20 MB. Now just proceed with the same tablespace name, that is number in front of the tablespace, that is 3. Enter 3 from your keyboard, hit enter, and it will show you the information about this particular tablespace, that is tablespace PSAP SR3 RAS 2 under options for extension of tablespace, and this is called input menu 303, and it is going to show you the information about your tablespace data file, that is SR3RAS2_3/SR3RAS2.data3 file has been added earlier. Now new file to be added is this, and last added file size in MB is 100 MB, and new file size, the size of the new file again it is 100 MB. You can also, if you want to change this particular 100 MB from here, you can select, you can type 5 from your keyboard and hit enter, so that it will give you the option to choose another size. Just I am accepting the defaults, and just again the command will be, command looks like this, that is alter tablespace PSAP SR3 RAS 2 add data files /oracle/dev/sap-data4/sr3-ras2_4, that is this is the folder which will be created under SAP data 4 folder, and the file name is sr3-ras2.data4, size 100 MB, auto extend on next, means 20 MB will be incremented when this 100 MB is filled up, and maximum size is this much, that is again 100 MB. Sorry, approximately 10 GB, it is 10 GB, up to 10 GB it will be extended. Okay, just type C from your keyboard, hit enter. And one more question it will ask, that is next data file can be specified now, do you want to perform this action? And I don't want to add any other files, just say no here. If you want, you can add one more file to this table space. So for this experiment to understand, just one file is enough. Just type N from your keyboard, hit enter. You see the file has been created, successfully created, and control file copy created, and switch to next online redo log file for Oracle database instance dev successful, means the online redo log file also switched. And the PSAP SR3 tablespace extended successfully with file. This is the file. Just go to the file level, go back, and from here just double click on this 4 folder. Under the 4 folder, one more file will be added. So in this way, you can extend the tablespace. You can also look this information from your SAP system. Just what you will do is just continue from here, come out from this screen. And exit program 5, type 5 from your keyboard, hit enter. And do you really want to exit BR space, enter SR no question, yes. And execution of BR space finished with return code 0, that means there is no error at all. So just type again C from your keyboard, hit enter. And this is the database space management choice menu 5. From here, if you want to come out, just again type B from, that is back, and this is the main menu, BR tools main menu, and exit program 9, hit enter, and it will ask you question again, do you really want to exit BR tools, enter yes or no, yes, and it is successfully exit. And BR tools completed successfully. Just type exit from this and come out from the screen, and even from here also you can come out. That means Oracle database is already started, and just we are coming out from that command prompt screen. So next is what, just let us start the SAP system. Oracle database is started, mounted, and it is open, but the SAP system to function, you have to start the SAP services, isn't it? So like how we have done in previous exercises, in the same way, just expand the SAP systems from this SAP management console. So once you expand this SAP systems, it should show all the SAP systems available in this system, that are all installed in this host will be shown, and now whatever the table space has been extended, that is for this database, because we have logged in as DVADM user account. So that means all the environment variables set for this particular user account are related to Dev Oracle database. You can view that information from here. Just go to environment variables, everything is related to the Dev. You see DBS underscore Aura underscore TNS name is Dev, and the Oracle home is Oracle slash Dev slash 102. Oracle underscore SID is Dev, and everything, all the folders, SAP data underscore home is SQL slash Oracle Dev. So that is the benefit of logging into the system using our corresponding user account, which will be created while you install SAP Network software. Okay, and now let us start this SAP system by right clicking here and click on the start and click OK here. Type the user password, that is DEVADM password, click OK and wait for some time until color turns to green and ASWP table comes. And first of all, the process list will be started. It will be started with the yellow color, that is message server is started, gateway reader is started, and dispatcher should be started. Once the dispatcher is started, ASWP table gives the information like this, that is start column should become yes and status column should become wait. Just click on the refresh button so that it will be done. So by this time we can log on to the SAP system, because some of the dialog work processes are showing wait status here. That means you can log on to the system. Anyway, again the green color also turns to green. Now happily you can log on to the SAP system using this SAP logon program, and it is called SAP NetView or SAP GUI for Windows. Just this is the entry, DEV, hit enter from the keyboard so that SAP initial screen will be displayed. From the initial screen, what you can do, you can log on to the SAP system using user account which is created by you. So I have created SAP user account here and just logging into the system. And once it is logged in, you will see SAP easy access screen. From here, DBA cockpit command you type, that is DBA cockpit, to administer Oracle database in your SAP systems, you have to use DBA cockpit T code, hit enter. And expand space for you, double click on space for you, and just click on the refresh to get the new statistics. Just refresh, click on S, and the background job refresh space statistics default is collecting new statistics. Just continue, it will take very fast, like it will be done very fast. Just directly go to table space to get the new statistics, double click on overview so that it will show the newly added file size, that is the file size has been that is table space total size increased to 320 MB, that is earlier it was 220 MB. That means first file 20 MB, second file 100 MB, third file 100 MB, now fourth file is added, that is 100 MB again. The total size of this particular table space became 320 MB. Just you see the files, number of files are 4. So that's all. I hope you understood how to extend table space in the Oracle database in an SAP system. And if you have any queries or doubts, you can log on to my website www.punarvasi.com, punervasi.com, and leave your comments there. Or you can also watch my YouTube channel for some of the free demo videos. Thanks for watching.